Hey guys, welcome back. So let's start off with the 42nd question. A patient was taking clonidine for the essential hypertension treatment, was using alcohol that caused the intense inhibition of central nervous system. What may be the connected with it? Okay. Here it's a simple thing, but we need to know the clonidine mechanism, right? Clonidine. What is clonidine? Clonidine is a alpha-2 agonist. Alpha-2 agonist. Now we need to know where is alpha-2 receptor located, yes or no? Alpha-2 receptor usually located in the presynaptic membrane of sympathetic neurons in central nervous system. Okay. Now what happens if I stimulate alpha-2, how it works? If I consider this to be a sympathetic neuron, okay. Now in sympathetic neuron, here I might have alpha-1, here I might have beta-1, here I might have beta-2, but alpha-2 is located somewhere here on the presynaptic membrane. Now whenever the neurotransmitters are released, they will stimulate the alpha-1, beta-1, beta-2, any of the receptor which is present on the postsynaptic membrane. At the same time, they will also stimulate the receptor which is present on the presynaptic membrane. When it gets stimulated, it will give what? It will give a negative feedback like mechanism. It's not exactly a negative feedback. I'm comparing it to a negative feedback means it will decrease the release. It will decrease the release of neurotransmitter. It will decrease the release. What it will decrease the release? It will decrease the release of neurotransmitter that includes adrenaline, noradrenaline. So by that way, if I use clonidine is a type of drug which will decrease the transmission. If it is decreasing the transmission, it's simple as that, directly or indirectly, it will decrease the central nervous system activity. Yes or no? At the same time, you add, for example, some alcohol to it. When you add some alcohol to it, alcohol is again CNS inhibitor. Yes or no? If it is a CNS inhibitor, what will happen when we combine both of these two things? The effect will become potentiating, means the clonidine effect will become more stronger, means clonidine is already a CNS inhibitor. If I add some alcohol, the effect of clonidine will be shown more. That is called as effect of potentiation. Effect of potentiation or potentiating effect. Now guys, the patient revealed what? Extremely myotic pupils, sleepiness, infrequent chain strokes respiration, urinary retention, slowing down of heart rate, enhancement of spinal reflexes. What substance caused the poisoning? Now the substance would be morphine. Why morphine? Let's see. Now what are the symptoms? We have myotic pupil. Okay, the patient is having sleepiness, means sedation. Okay, then there is a decreased respiratory rate and infrequent breathing, and the patient is having urinary retention and decrease of heart rate. All of these are the symptoms associated with opioid poisoning. How do I know opioid poisoning caused these symptoms? Earlier in one question I was discussing opioid receptor stimulation. If I use a opioid, that was doing what? Decreasing the sympathetic outflow, leading to what? Meiosis. Yes or no? Then the patient will also have sedation, because stimulation of mu, kappa and delta receptor will cause what? Sedation. That will also cause bradycardia. These are the symptoms associated with even there is a decreased reflexes. Those are the symptoms associated with opioid poisoning. One of the classic prototype opioid which we need to know is morphine. Now if they give the same question and if they diagnose the patient with opioid poisoning or morphine poisoning, what will be the antidote? That will be the next question. The antidote would be what? Naloxone. The antidote would be Naloxone. Clear? So this is the story of our morphine. Chalo, let's go to the next question. The next question here, the patient suffering from the diabetes mellitus. Okay, after regular insulin injection, his condition grew worse. There appeared a anxiety, cold sweat, tremor of the limbs, general weakness and the dizziness. What preparation can eliminate the symptoms? Now, the patient was having what? Diabetes mellitus. For diabetes mellitus, he took insulin. When he took insulin, he develops some symptoms. Those symptoms are indicating what hypoglycemia, because anxiety, cold sweat, tremor of limbs, general weakness, dizziness. These are the classic symptoms associated with hyperglycemia. Means he would have taken a little more quantity of insulin, that would have caused the hypoglycemia. When hypoglycemia happens, the treatment would be glucose. The treatment would be glucose. But if glucose is not in the option, among the given options, adrenaline is the only substance which elevates the glucose. That's why we use adrenaline. If adrenaline is given in the option along with then another option, glucose, I would prefer glucose as an answer. Continuous taking of some drugs, foregoing the pregnancy increases the risk of giving birth to a child with genetic defect. We need to pay attention. There is a genetic defect. Genetic defect means there should be a mutation. So if the drug causes the genetic defect, we call it as what? Mutation. So mutagenic effect. If the drug is causing genetic defect, that is a type of mutagenic effect. Now, a doctor administered a patient with an allergic dermatitis, a H1 blocker, as a part of complex treatment. Doctor gave him H1 blocker. We already discussed H1 blocker. H1 blockers are divided into first gen, second gen. In the second gen, we had some drugs such as loratadine, yes or no? We have desloratadine, we have cetirizine, we have levocetirizine. Now, all these drugs are what? These are the second generation. Now, where do we use the antihistamines? Antihistamine drugs are used in all type of allergic condition. So, the drugs which we could use among the given options, the loratadine is the best answer. Why not cromolyn sodium? Cromolyn sodium is a mast cell stabilizer. Antihistamine drug. Now, the next thing is prednisolone. I agree, prednisolone could be used in the allergy, but prednisolone is a steroid. Since prednisolone is a steroid, we cannot use prednisolone, because the question asked here is what? H1 antihistamine. Okay. Now, adrenaline is an adrenomimetic that is used in the anaphylactic shock of the allergy. Hydrocortisone is again similar to that of prednisolone. We cannot use it. The best answer would be loratadine. Okay. 47th question. A 19-year-old woman suffering from the syphilis. Okay, she's suffering from the syphilis. Doctor administered her a complex therapy that includes benzyl penicillin. Okay, the drug of one of the important drugs for the syphilis treatment will be penicillin. Agreed. What is the mechanism of action of this drug? So they asked, what is the mechanism of action of penicillin? Penicillin is a benzyl penicillin. Benzyl penicillin is a type of penicillin. What is the mechanism of action of penicillin? Let's make it easy. Penicillin is a cell wall synthesis inhibitor. When penicillin is a cell wall synthesis inhibitor, what it does? Cell wall synthesis inhibitor means it is a type of bactericidal antibiotic. When it is a bactericidal antibiotic, it is a cell wall synthesis inhibitor. We need to know what cell wall is made out of. What cell wall of a bacteria will be made out of? Something called peptidoglycan. Now, if I ask you what is the mechanism of action of penicillin, you should be able to understand one thing: peptidoglycan synthesis inhibitor, which is present where? Which is present in the bacterial cell wall. A patient suffering from the chronic renal insufficiency accompanied by edema caused by the chronic glomerulonephritis. Now, we need to pay attention, guys. If a patient has an edema, We need to treat edema. Edema will be treated by some group of drugs called as diuretics. Now, best diuretics for the treatment of edema will be loop diuretics. Why loop diuretics will be best during edema, during the emergencies? Because they are the high ceiling diuretics. They are called as high ceiling diuretic. What do I mean by high ceiling diuretic? Means they are the potent diuretics. So that is why we use them. Loop diuretics include furosemide and one more thing is ethacrine acid. Okay, so that is why if the patient is having a edema and we need to cause a forced diuresis, always remember for forced diuresis, loop diuretics are used. The drug of choice for a forced diuresis will be loop diuretics. Always remember that includes furosemide. Now, let's discuss a disease before going to the next question, that is named as angina. Guys, angina, we have coronary vessels, right? So, in coronary vessels, let's take this is one coronary vessel. which is going, which is further dividing into small branches. It is supplying some part of the heart, blood supply to the heart. Okay. Now what happens? There is some atherosclerosis sitting in this part of the blood vessel. When there is atherosclerosis sitting in part of the vessel, now this patient will start to work out, means he will start to run or do some excess. Now what will happen? Heart will be needing more oxygen, yes or no, to work, means increased demand of the oxygen, increased demand of O2. At the same time, with the increased demand of O2, there is a decreased supply because the blood vessel is narrowed. There is a decreased blood supply. When there is a decreased blood supply and increased demand, this condition we call it as angina. Now, how to treat angina? How to treat angina? Angina treatment is very simple. First thing, increase the supply. Increase the supply. How do you increase the supply? By causing a vasodilation. How do you cause vasodilation? Vasodilation is caused by some drugs called as nitrates. Which are those nitrates? They are called as organonitrates. Organonitrates do what? Organonitrates will produce some substance called as NO. NO will do what? Vasodilation. When vasodilation happens, vasodilation. The other way, decrease the demand. We can use beta blockers. Yes or no? So this is one of the way of the treating the people with the angina. Now vasodilation is caused, but if I give more of organonitrate, if I increase organonitrate, increase NO, increase vasodilation means systemic vasodilation. If systemic vasodilation means decrease of the blood pressure. If BP decreases, if the person's BP decreases from a normal, our heart rate will increase to increase the blood supply to increase the blood pressure. Our heart rate will increase as a compensatory. We call it as reflex tachycardia. Now let's see the question for number 49. A patient suffering from the coronary artery disease had taken a certain drug that many times a day in order to arrest the stenocardia attacks. Stenocardia attacks is nothing but angina attack. Okay. Overdose of this drug finally caused intoxication and cyanosis and mucous membrane's dramatic fall in the blood pressure, tachycardia, respiratory inhibition. Now what are these drugs? The drugs will be organonitrates. Yes or no? Okay. Now 50th question, you need to remember this question directly. A child was born asphyxiated. During the asphyxia, we need to stimulate the respiration. Asphyxia is nothing but the child would have had some problem while going through the birth canal, maybe strangulation or maybe compression of the umbilical cord leading to the decreased blood supply to the baby, since baby's lungs will not be active during the labor. Okay. Now what drug must be administered to the newborn to stimulate? Now it is considered atemisolum is a drug. It is considered that it will stimulate the respiratory stimulation, means it will stimulate the drive for the respiration. So it is a direct thing to remember, not much mechanism to be explained. Now let's come to the next question, the question number 51. A patient with stage 2 hypertension has been taking one of the hypotensive medication for the purpose of treatment. After a time, arterial pressure decreased, but the patient started complaining of flaccidity, sleepiness, indifference. A bit later, he felt stomach pain. He was diagnosed with the ulcer. What hypertensive medication was taken? Okay. Now, one thing we need to know, among all of those things, furosemide can be used during the hypertension. Not every condition. For emergency cases, we can use. Now, why the answer would be reserpine? We need to understand the mechanism of reserpine. Now, what reserpine does, guys, if I take, this is a sympathetic neuron. Whatever the adrenaline, noradrenaline, dopamine, they are called as monoamines, which are released. Monoamines will be reuptaken. Okay. Now reuptaken by a transporter. Now what this reserpine does? It will block the transporter. All the monoamines will be metabolized. Means there is no more monoamines. If there is no more monoamines, there is no more stimulation of the postsynaptic membrane and no more stimulation of the hypertension. At the same time, if monoamines are not there, the patient will start to have flaccidity and sleepiness in the center, because this happens in the central nervous system. In central nervous system, when I don't have monoamines, the patient will develop the side effects of the flaccidity and sleepiness, and that might indirectly even lead to the ulcer. But most importantly, the reserpine is a drug which is doing what? Inhibit the transport of monoamines. That is how it is treating the hypotension. At the same time, flaccidity and sleepiness will be a side effect. So this is a story of our reserpine. Let's go to the 52nd question. A child suffering from the drug idiosyncrasy. Okay, the child is having drug idiosyncrasy. Idiosyncrasy is nothing but it's an undesired effect. What do I mean by undesired effect? It is not shown in every person. Guys, for example, I have a drug A. drug A has a side effect. Now this side effect will be shown in all populations. Side effect will be shown in all population. It's possible. But what happens when I'm talking about idiosyncrasy? Idiosyncrasy is an undesired effect seen in few people. Seen in few people, one of the important cause for the idiosyncrasy is some deficiency of some enzyme. The most important cause for idiosyncrasy would be enzymopathy, because the most important cause for deficiency of most important cause of idiosyncrasy would be deficiency of enzymes. So enzymopathy is a cause for drug idiosyncrasy. Now 53rd question, when I'm talking a patient with the insulin dependent diabetes, if the person is having insulin dependent diabetes mellitus, the treatment will be what? Insulin. Treatment will be insulin. But in these few questions, they mentioned it as a gibenclamide. Gibenclamide is a drug which increase the production of insulin. Okay. When option contains insulin directly as an answer, and still I don't know why they ask us to refer gibenclamide, but my preference would be insulin. For the preparation of a patient's burn skin surface, a certain medication was used. It is an antiseptic action provided free oxygen that generates the presence of the organic organic substances. Choose the correct answer. Now the thing is, they asked which of the following substance will produce free oxygen. Now let's look at the formula of potassium permanganate. That will be KMnO4. When it is a KMnO4, that will really give free oxygen. That will be sometimes toxic to some bacteria, that will kill the bacteria. To control the infection, we can use potassium permanganate as an antiseptic during the burns. Now a patient is having a chronic cardiac insufficiency. The treatment will be what? Treatment will be cardiac glycosides. Which cardiac glycosides we know? One of the most important cardiac glycoside is what? Digoxin. Digoxin is a drug of choice in chronic heart failure. Now the mechanism of action of digoxin, it blocks sodium potassium ATPase. Now if you want to learn the full mechanism, I don't want to waste time here. You can learn it. There is a video for this. You can go learn it on my channel. Okay. Now this is a chronic, it is used in the chronic heart failure. Digoxin, one important aspect, every time I tell digoxin, I used to mention this one. It is a vagomimetic also. It is a vagomimetic. As a side effect, it will cause bradycardia, vagomimetic effect. It will lead to bradycardia as a side effect. It is a vagomimetic drug. So this is a story of our digoxin. Okay. And they asked which group of cardiac glycoside to be taken, that will be digoxin. Again, same question. Okay, let's discuss about alpha 1 receptor. Till now I told you alpha 1 receptors are located in the blood vessel and urinary bladder sphincter. Now I will mention one more location, that will be in the eye. Okay. Now alpha 1 receptor, if I stimulate in the eye, it will cause something called mydriasis. Mydriasis is nothing but dilation of the pupil. Okay. Now why I need to dilate the pupil to do the fundoscopy? When I'm doing a fundoscopy, I need to look into the eye with a special equipment called as fundoscope. So during that, I need to have a dilated pupil. For the dilation of pupil, we can use a drug called as mesotone. That will cause what? Activation of alpha 1 receptor. When alpha 1 receptor gets stimulated, that will cause mydriasis, that is dilation. That will be helpful for our fundoscopic examination. Now the next question. Mother of a 2-year-old child consulted a stomatologist, means she consulted a dentist, and she says that in the period of pregnancy, she was irregularly taking some antibiotic for an infectious disease. Okay. Examination, the child revealed incisor destruction, yellow enamel, brown rim around the dental cervix. What teratogenic has happened? Okay. The baby has what? Yellow teeth. Everything in the mouth, all the teeth and other tissues surrounding the teeth has turned yellow. Yes, sir. Now we need to know which drug will cause yellow teeth. Yellow teeth, for example, if doxycycline taken during pregnancy, what will happen? That will lead to a teratogenic effect on baby. That will be yellow discoloration of the teeth. Yellow discoloration of the teeth. Now, it is a type of protein synthesis inhibitor antibiotic. It is a sort of broad spectrum, wide spectrum antibiotic. It is a drug of choice for all sort of vector-borne diseases. Most of the vector-borne diseases, the drug will be used will be, this is the one that is doxycycline. Doxycycline is a drug which has a wide spectrum, and as a side effect, it will cause yellow discoloration of teeth in the babies if mother use the drug. If the mother use the drug, if a pregnant mother use the drug, the baby will develop this side effect. Apart from that, in a normal adult, it will cause photosensitivity. Photosensitivity. What do I mean by photosensitivity? If you and me, we take this drug and walk around in sun, sometimes it will cause a rash, that is called photosensitivity. And what is the mechanism of action of doxycycline? It is a protein synthesis inhibitor. Okay. A man has a craniocerebral trauma, objectively diminished breath sounds, 3D pulse, no reflexes. What way of paracetam introduction would be the most appropriate? See, in every emergency, the best way to give drug will be intravenous, because in this condition, we cannot give orally and wait for the drug to be absorbed, or the patient cannot take the drug orally. We cannot give rectally and wait for the drug to get absorbed. Most bioavailability, most fast effective action will be given by the intravenous action. Now, what is this paracetam? Paracetam is a nootropic drug. Which increase the brain metabolism. Okay. Now, the 60th question, guys, I am telling you one simple thing. In most of the questions which are like, you know, given for the croak point of view, this croak exam, Ukrainian croak exam point of view, if the question asks you chronic heart failure, the drug of choice will be digoxin. Okay. If they ask you acute heart failure and the question specifies the cardiac glycoside, okay, or a steroidal drug, the answer would be carglycone. But at the same time, if the question specifies ionotropic, the answer would be dobutamine, because ionotropic, that is a classic thing followed everywhere, ionotropic agent, which is a beta mimetic. The answer would be dobutamine. Dobutamine is what? Dobutamine is a beta 1 mimetic. It will stimulate the beta 1 receptor. It will help in the treatment of acute heart failure. If they mention ionotropic, you need to choose the answer as dobutamine, because that will be the beta 1. If they ask you, this is some random thing which you need to follow. If it is acute heart failure and if they ask you as a cardiac glycoside, the answer would be carglycone. A patient suffering from the initial hypertension has been taking antihypertensive preparation for a long time. Suddenly he stopped taking. If they suddenly stop taking, the patient develops some symptoms, and that would be explained by withdrawal syndrome or a abstinence syndrome. This is called as other name for withdrawal syndrome is nothing but abstinence syndrome. But what happens, he suddenly stopped taking the drug. After that, his condition grew worse and led to severe hypertensive crisis. That will be abstinence syndrome. Other name for abstinence syndrome would be hypertensive. Abstinence syndrome will be not hypertension, I'm sorry, that will be withdrawal syndrome. Now, a patient ill with the bronchial asthma did not inform his doctor he had attacks of tenocardia. Okay, see, he's suffering from asthma. He didn't tell his doctor that he's having stenocardia, nothing but angina. Doctor administered him a medication which resulted in the less frequent attacks of bronchial asthma, but stenocardia attacks became more frequent. Means the doctor used Isadrine is nothing but isoproterenol is a drug which will stimulate beta 1 and beta 2 receptor, which will stimulate this receptor. Okay, when beta 1 will get stimulated, that will lead to increased heart rate, increased force of contraction. At the same time, that will lead to increased O2 demand in the heart. When it has an increased O2 demand in the heart, what will happen? He is already having angina. Angina, just a few questions back, we discussed that angina is a increase in the demand and decrease in the supply, and angina attacks will become more worse. Beta 2 stimulation will lead to bronchodilation. So he is having asthma. It causes bronchodilation. Bronchiolasma is treated. Yes or no? But the problem would be associated with beta 1 stimulation. Beta 1 stimulation will lead to what? Increase O2 demand, that will worsen the angina attacks. Okay. So a patient who is suffering from the cardiac insufficiency for several months has been taking the digoxin on an outpatient basis. He is taking digoxin on an outpatient basis. At a certain stage, there appear the symptoms of drug overdose. Why drug overdose happens in the digoxin? Because drug accumulates in the body. Okay. Now the drug accumulation can be of two types. That can be material accumulation. Okay. That can be functional accumulation. Now, functional accumulation means there is no drug, but the only effect is existing in the body. Effect is existing in the body. But material accumulation, the drug itself is present. Because of drug itself is present inside the body, which is not eliminated, that will cause the side effect. That is called as material accumulation. So two types of accumulation, material and functional. Functional, drug is eliminated from the body, no drug, but only effect is remnant. But in material accumulation, what is happening? Material accumulation, drug is present inside the body, that is causing the side effect. So this is about our material accumulation. Now a patient in this question, for some, it varies every place. In Ukraine they follow cotrimaxazole is a drug of choice for toxoplasmosis. Just you need to remember this question for your croak exam. After 4 months of treatment for tuberculosis, a patient began complaining of toes finger numbness. Guys, remember isoniazid, I already told you, it is a hepatotoxic, but the other side effect with this one will be peripheral neuropathy. When it causes peripheral neuropathy, what do I mean by peripheral neuropathy? Means it will cause numbness in the extremities, such as in the fingers and in the toes. So what will be the side effect? He was taking anti-TB drug and he developed what? Polyneuritis. That is, polyneuritis is nothing but peripheral neuropathy, that is caused due to a drug called as isoniazid. But rifampicin causes red color urine and red color sweat, so red color body fluid. Now 66th question, that I don't have to explain. A patient suffering from the vision impairment, hemerlopy, that is night blindness, what type of vitamin preparation should be administered? So if vitamin A deficiency is there, the other name for vitamin A is a retinol acetate used for the treatment of vitamin A deficiency. Vitamin A, other name is retinoic acid. 67. A patient suffer from the severe post-operative Pseudomonas infection. This one also you need to remember, because Pseudomonas, usually we use anti-Pseudomonas penicillin, but some, in every place, anti-Pseudomonal drug of choice varies. In Ukraine, it is considered to be post-operative Pseudomonas infection. The drug of choice is amikacin. Amikacin is a drug of choice in this condition. It's an antibiotic. Now, well, amikacin, what type of drug it is? It's a type of macrolide. Okay. Now, this amikacin is a type of macrolide. It is a protein synthesis inhibitor. It is also a type of protein synthesis inhibitor. Okay. After tooth extraction, a patient felt persistent pain behind his breast bone. Okay, after sublingual intake of anti-anginal, during the pain, the pain behind the breastbone disappeared, but the patient complained of headache and dizziness. What will be the typical, guys, due to vasodilation, what will be the side effect? Let's see, because what I'm trying to explain is he developed angina. For angina, they gave him nitroglycerin. I will write it as NTG. NTG will cause vasodilation. Due to vasodilation, one good effect is treatment of angina. The side effect with the vasodilation would be classic side effect associated with nitroglycerin. You need to remember, that will be headache. Okay, the patient develops headache and dizziness. Due to vasodilation, decreased blood pressure, decreased BP. When BP decreases, that can lead to slight of dizziness. But classic side effect associated with nitroglycerin, which you need to remember, is vasodilation leading to headache. The drug would be now nitroglycerin. So this much is about this video. I'll try to continue the other questions later. Thank you. Hey guys, let's discuss.